Hola estudiantes, bienvenidos a mi clase el día de hoy. Ayer trabajamos la expresión buen provecho. Español 1, bloque 1, hoy es día miércoles, septiembre 7 del año 2020. Ok, was buen provecho. Ok, bon appetit. Today we're going to work on escúchame, listen to me. Maybe your teachers are asking you to listen to them, or maybe your mom, your dad tells you to listen to them, all right? Escúchame, listen to me. All right, guys, today in Español 1, vamos a trabajar descripciones. I would say that this is the last class about descriptions because tomorrow we're going to start a new class about articles, definite and indefinite articles, all right? So, estudiantes pueden describir personas. That is the student's objective for today. That's my purpose. So, we are reinforcing every day about descriptions. And today, we're going to finish the prayer deck, and also, you're going to create your poem in the diamond shape form about yourself. Okay, guys? So, that's all for today. I hope you put in practice everything you learned so far. Adiós. Nos vemos más tarde. Chao. Excelente trabajo, chicos. Muy bien, excelente trabajo para el día de hoy. Vamos con buen provecho. Fue ayer. Yesterday we worked this expression, buen provecho. I hope that some of you guys use this in your common daily expressions and at home in the cafeteria. Buen provecho. Try to use it, guys. Don't feel ashamed of doing it. Today I'm going to introduce, escúchame. Listen to me. Listen to your dad. Listen to your officer. Listen to Mr. Campbell, listen to all the people, all right? Listen to, escúchame. Escúchame, I'm going to explain comparativos today. Escúchame, voy a explicar comparativos today. Okay, Spanish 2, bloque 2. Today, it is October 7 del año 2020. Las comparaciones again. We're going to, students are able to do comparisons, okay? So, pueden hacer comparaciones, and we have a practical application. On this side of the board, we have that María has 5 cats. Y aquí tenemos que Sandra tiene the same number of cats. So, if they have the same number of cats, we're going to say, María tiene tantos gatos como Sandra. As many cats as Sandra. María has as many cats as Sandra. So, they have the same number of cats. Also, we have example number 2, Reagan, soccer player. Metió 3 goles, scored 3 goals. But also, Amelia, another girl, in the soccer team, metió 3 goles, scored 3 goals. So, Regan metió tantos goles como Amelia. The same number of goals. These are countable nouns, nouns, okay? So, we have here comparisons. The same number of goals they made. Here we got Dylan sacó 100 en español. Dylan got, sacó buena nota, 100 en español. And also Whitney sacó 100 en español. What does it mean? It means that they are really intelligent. Both are really, really intelligent. So we can say, Dylan es tan inteligente como Whitney. Here we are comparing with adjectives. Comparing adjectives. Here we are comparing with nouns. Remember, guys, in nouns, we have to bear in mind affirmative, negative, and also we need to make sure if they are. Number and gender. If it is plural, if it is singular, if it is feminine, or if it is masculine. Okay, guys, so that's the word for today. Also, we're going to finish per deck, the 2 per decks that are really on standby. And, well, there is a coming a project about art. We need to compare art. I'm going to explain that project. Maybe on Thursday or Friday. It's going to be a big, big project for next week. Okay, guys, so I hope you learned something today and just put in practice that. Don't forget, we have a pop quiz today about comparisons. Have a great day. Nos vemos. Ciao. ¿Qué tal si utilizamos buen provecho para cada vez oportunidad que tengamos para compartir una cena, un almuerzo, un desayuno con alguien? Buen provecho. Today, voy a introducir, escúchame. Maybe your teachers, your mom, your dad, I do too. Listen to them. Listen, escúchame. I'm talking, escúchame. Maybe your friends. Hey, you know what? Escúchame. I need to talk to you about something special. Okay? Escúchame. Listen to me. Listen to me. Escúchame. Okay, guys, we continue now with this entrevista. We have been working on this interview for a couple of days, yesterday and today. We will finish that interview because tomorrow we're going to shot the video or to produce the audio. Okay, guys, so I just brought you this entrevista. Today is October the 7th, miércoles. Oh, we're in the half of the week. Español 3, bloque 3, accelerated. So we have students can formulate and respond or answer questions about sports or about an athlete or about a famous sportsman or a sportswoman. Okay, guys, what about, I'm suggesting you some more ideas, as I said before, including but not limited to what? La entrevista, you can use, for example, en qué ha participado, competitions, contests, tournaments, that person has already participated. ¿Qué ropa usa? What clothing? What clothes that person wear when he or she's practicing or training? ¿Quién es? Who is that person? ¿De dónde es? ¿De dónde es? ¿Cómo es? What about giving me here personality descriptors or maybe personal descriptions like physical appearance? Physical appearance or personality. ¿Juega en equipo o solo? Does he play in a team or does he play individually? Okay. ¿Por qué es deportista? Why? Why did he make that decision or why did she make that decision to be an athlete? ¿Dónde entrena? Give me the place where he or she trains. ¿Qué premios ha ganado? What awards or prizes or tournaments or trophies or medals has he won so far? ¿Cómo es su familia? Tell me about his family or her family. And also, ¿cómo es su dieta y su entrenamiento? Tell me about his or her diet and the training. Well, guys, we have a lot of ideas about this. Remember, 20 questions, answering 20 questions and formulating 20 questions. Okay, guys, just keep on working on this and enjoy your activity. Have a good day. Bye-bye. Adiós. Nos vemos. Chao. Hasta pronto.